This is a pre-built version of the application. So let's go ahead and run it. And we'll have three peers that are trying to communicate, and one eavesdropper peer. So this one will be picking up the messages coming from all three communicating peers. And this one will be picking up messages coming from this one. And this one will pick messages coming from this one. And this one from this one. So Diffie-Hellman key exchange is not limited to two peers. It is possible to have any number of peers with no prior knowledge of each other to jointly establish a shared secret key over an insecure network. And P is a prime, and alpha is a primitive root modulo P. Now suppose that Alice, Bob, and Carla agree to use P equal 467 and alpha to be 2. And for the purpose of this prototype application, I had the first user that logs in, Alice in this case, enters the value for P and alpha. So here, passive Eve. Will be able to see those values. So let's suppose that Alice picks 3 as her secret number. So passive Eve here can see the value for P and the value for alpha. And so what Alice did is to send those values to Bob, and Bob in turn sends them to Carla. So this is when Alice sends them to Bob, and this is when Bob sends them to, actually this is when Alice sends them to Bob, and this is when Bob sends them to Carla. Let's suppose that Bob picks his secret number to be 5, and Carla picks her secret number to be 7. So they ended up with this common key, 444 mod 467. What happened is Alice calculated alpha to the power of lowercase a, so 2 to the power of 3, and sent it to Bob. So end up with 8, and this is Alice sending it to Bob. And what Bob does is takes alpha to the power of a and takes the power of b for that, his secret key. So we end up with 78, and Bob in turn sends that to Carla, and she calculates alpha to the power of a to the power of b to the power of her secret key c. So here we go, and she end up with a common key, and now Bob also in turn takes alpha to the power of his secret key b. So we end up with 32, and he sends it to Carla, and Carla takes alpha to the power of b to the power of her secret key c. So 416, and Carla in turn sends this alpha to the power of b to the power of c to Alice. And what Alice does is it takes it and takes the power of her secret key for that. So alpha to the power of b to the power of c to the power of a, and we end up with a common key. Now also Carla here takes alpha to the power of her secret key, and she sends it to Alice, and Alice takes that and take it to the power of her secret key. So we end up with 322 in mod P, and Alice sent that value to Bob, and Bob here takes alpha to the power of C to the power of A to the power of B in mod P, and he gets the common key. So all three parties, Alice, Bob, and Carla, established a shared secret key over an insecure network. Now only the secret key for Alice, lowercase a, the secret key of Bob, lowercase b, and the secret key for Carla, lowercase c, and the computed shared secret key are kept secret, so the common key. All other values are sent in the clear, so passive Eve can see alpha to the power of a. She can see alpha to the power of a to the power of b. She can see alpha to the power of b, and alpha to the power of b to the power of c, and alpha to the power of c, and alpha to the power of c to the power of a. But she cannot use any combination of those to efficiently reproduce alpha to the power of a, b, c. Now much larger values would be needed here to make this example secure. And the source code for this will be available for download. Also, a longer version will be available for watching by channel members, and it will include step-by-step coding plus test running the coded application.